Dear students, a very very good morning all of you. I will deliver today the lecture on enthalpy, which is also known as heat contents of BSc part 2 as unit 1. First of all, before delivering the lecture on enthalpy, I will repeat once again the contents delivered to till today, including Joule experiment, the measurement of internal pressure PI is also known as Joule experiment's value and Joule's apparatus here. Yesterday, we have also calculated the measurement of change in internal energy with respect to the volume, keeping state variable temperature as a constant. This value actually shows the value of internal pressure here. We have also concluded in Joule's experiment that change in internal energy is independent upon volume but dependent upon temperature. I mean to say, in Joule experiment, internal energy depending upon temperature but independent upon that is of volume. In the series of various topics of Unit 1 is Thermodynamic 1 of BSc Part 2, second one, topics, once again I repeat, we delivered yesterday, that is internal energy. Yesterday we have also delivered, we have also defined about internal energy, which is mainly concerned the mass of the matter and is the origin, and it developed from the rotational, translational, vibrational degree of freedom of the molecules. Also, the value of internal energy in cyclic process can be expressed as that is of zero. It is state function. State function, that is which is depending upon initial and final state but independent upon that is of path functions here. And internal energy, that can be symbolized by du, or that is of del E, d for infinitesimal, and it is concerned with that is of first law of TD. I mentioned on that is of blackboard, delta Q is equal to delta U plus that is of delta, that is of W here. We also calculate the above value of internal energy at that is of constant volume, that is known as heat capacity at constant volume. CV to absorb the heat, in order to explain about heat capacity, that is of CV, the heat taken to the system, absorbed heat, delta Q, this will be equal to that is of del U here. The required heat is known as that is of heat capacity at constant volume, and is that is of symbolized by that is of a CV here. Once again here, that is of if absorbed heat for any system which is given to the heat, and its value one can express as equals to that is of delta U and divisible by that is of temperature. This value is known as that is of heat capacity at constant volume here. And its dimension one can express as calorie upon that is of temperature, and units one can express as that is of for 1 mole, calorie mole inverse, that is of temperature inverse. I repeat once again the definition of heat capacity at constant volume here. Suppose I select here this box as that is of a system here, any quantity of heat symbolized by that is of delta Q. Delta Q is given to this system, keeping state variable volume as a constant. In that case, the absorbed heat delta Q, this will be equal to that is of delta V here, and divided by that is of temperature dT. I meant to say, the absorbed heat to increase the temperature of dT, or that is of 1 degree Celsius, this specific physical quantity will be known as heat capacity at that is of constant volume and is symbolized by that is of CV. Today I will deliver very very second one important physical quantity, that is of enthalpy. Topic here T denotes for topic, and enthalpy or that is of, it is also named as that is of heat contents. why it is named as that is of heat contents. Heat contents, the important feature I focus here, it is mainly concerned with the degree of hotness or that is of temperature. Listen to me once again here, and it is defined as that is of pressure remains the constant here. In the case of that is of internal energy. Internal energy, that is you mentioned here, that is of internal energy is defined. Internal energy is defined at constant volume. Second one, the important physical quantities, which is defined at that is of a constant pressure. Dear students, in that is of BSc part 1, in BSc part 2, in unit 1 and that is of unit 2, you have to be submitted the 4 or 5 important physical quantities here, that is internal energy, enthalpy H, Gibbs free energy G, Helmholtz free energy, that is of A, internal energy U or E. We have delivered, we have discussed about important features of internal energy. Today I will deliver the lecture on that is of enthalpy. It is important regarding to that is of important features. It is to define as degree of hotness. I mean that is of regarding to that is of heat. It is defined at constant pressure, at constant volume defined, that is of internal energy here. Next postulate, it is derived enthalpy or heat contents defined as that is of pressure as a constant here. Now it is derived from that is of first law of TD here. Since we know that by using that is of perfect conceptual of first law of TD, delta Q is equals to del U plus that is of delta W here. Delta Q denotes here PF means path function, del U denotes for that is of state function, delta W that is of PF path functions, delta W is equals to that is of P del V, and delta Q is equals to that is of del U will be written as such, and delta W replaced by that is of P del V. Now to solve the any physical quantities or state variable, tick mark here on that is of del U and that is of del V. Here I want to code out to here, that is of del U and that is of del V, that is of a point here, that is of del U and del V, that is of SF, SM is that is of state function. So it becomes essential to apply the conditions of here, that is of state function here. Del U, I have just delivered to you, that is of del U, state function. State function is can be written and is symbolized by state, that is of 1 and 2, and one can write here del U is equals to U2 minus U1. Similarly, volume del V denotes here state function. Similarly, we may write that is of V2 minus that is of V1. Say equation number 3, say equation number 4. Now put down equation number 3 and 4 in equation number that is of 2 here. Delta Q is equals to del U is replaced by U2 minus U1 plus P del V is replaced by U2 minus that is of V1. Del Q is equals to U2 minus U1 plus multiply by constant pressure, because first law or heat enthalpy is now defined as constant pressure here. The pressure will be remains then constant here. P is now multiplied by V2 to give the value of PV2 minus P, that is of PV1 here. So delta Q is equals to here, and that is of on solving here, delta Q is equals to U2 plus that is of PV2, taking the common of minus sign, inside remains the quantity of U1 plus that is of PV1. Say any T equation here. Now I state here equation number T, that is the compact form of two important term, that is of term first and that is of term second here. Term first here, delta Q is equals to H2 minus that is of H1. You may also write down here that is of second term here. You may also that is write down here this one, term one that is of first one and that is of term second two here. The second two that is of will be replaced by a new important thermodynamic quantity, that is H2. minus that is of H1. This one quantity is replaced by that is of H1. Amazing thermodynamic quantity now appears here, is developed here. That is it. Here H2 is equals to U2 plus PV2. Similarly, H1 is equals to U1 plus PV1 to define a very special thermodynamic quantity in unit 1 here. It will be defined so many ways that this quantity, which is formed by that is of three important state variable or quantity, including that is of internal energy, pressure, and that is volume. The sum of three important quantities or state variable is known as that is of enthalpy. Listen to me, dear student, once again, the quantity which is formed by three important quantity, three important state variable, including here that is of internal energy is symbolized by U2, pressure as that is of P, volume as that is of V2. Here 2 denotes state 2. Similarly, in the case of term 1 will be replaced by as that is of U1 plus PV1 here. H1 will be now coded, will be written here into the form of first one state function here. H1 is equals to U1 plus P1 at constant pressure. Delta QB is equals to this one quantity. This one quantity will be must be written here in equation number 5B. Say this one, that is of equation number 5A. I mean to say enthalpy which is formed, I define here the heat contents which is formed by that is of three important quantity here and having the property of state functions here. It is evident, obviously it is evident, it has that is of 2 points 1 and 2 indicating the presence of the property of state function here, that is of delta QP is equal to del H. Once again I would like to define to you CV del U, and that is of here I mention here, if this suppose I am assuming here, I consider here this system here, and it will be given, I give to the heat at constant volume, the physical quantity will be known as to appear as that is of internal energy while keeping volume as a state variable. Suppose I choose this box, this container as a system here, and I give to this system heat by keeping that is of pressure as a constant. In such a case, the quantity, the physical quantity, the internal system to occupy internal physical quantity is developed, it present, it will be known as that is of enthalpy or that is of heat contents here. Once again, at constant pressure, heat is known as energy, known as enthalpy. At constant volume, keeping volume, the new thermodynamic quantity will be known as that is of internal energy. In compact form, I would like to once again here, at constant volume, energy is given, known as internal energy. At keeping state variable pressure as a constant here, the heat will be known as that is of enthalpy here. Now, next topic I will deliver to you very, very outstanding and amazing, very special topic, that is of here enthalpy, and that is of its change at constant pressure. In previous case, I mentioned yesterday here internal energy, keeping that is of state variable volume as a constant here. Now I proceed this topic of thermodynamic BSc part 2 unit 1 here, that is of now I am taking a new quantity, physical quantity enthalpy del H, and its change at constant pressure P as a constant here. Now let us that is of proceed here. The new quantity keeping pressure as a constant here is known as that is of heat capacity Cp at constant pressure here. Let us proceed here. I choose here enthalpy as a measure, thermodynamic quantity is symbolized by that is of enthalpy H. It is depending upon two state variable, taking temperature and that is of a pressure. Say equation number that is of 6, its TD equation one can write here dH is equal to delta H delta Tp dT plus delta H delta Pt at dP. Here state function, path function, state function, path functions, path functions, state function, say that is of equation number 7. Now applying a that is of a P is equal to constant, And now by conditions, apply P is equals to constant, dP is equals to 0, so then delta QP becomes is equals to P here, that is of, in this case here we apply that is of dH becomes is equals to that is of delta QP. Next one, delta QP, delta HT, this things will be as such, dP is equals to 0, so next value that is comes out that is of delta QP. Putting down here delta QP will be is equals to del H this dH, keeping pressure as a constant here, this term dH will be replaced by that is of delta QP, two major changes here, dP will be is equals to 0, dH will be is equals to delta QP, as by conditions we apply, that is of, on applying the given condition, pressure is a constant here, dP is equals to 0, and now dH is replaced by that is of delta QP, so delta QP is equals to del H, del T, P keeping temperature, dT as a dT, and CP is equal to the ratio of delta QP upon that is of dT, this one that is of rest quantity, at the right hand side delta H upon delta TP, one can write here that is of CP is equals to delta H delta TP, and that is of at amazing specific special quantity of form, thermodynamic we do that is of existing here, that is keeping pressure as a constant here, the absorbed heat which is equals to that is of del H to increase the temperature by dT in known a new quantity is known as heat capacity. Similarly, on the behalf of, it is evident, obviously from equation number this one 8, where pressure remains a constant, keeping state variable pressure as a constant here, to increase the temperature of this one system by that is of 1 degree Celsius or that is of dT, the absorbed heat that is of delta QP, this will be equal to del H, and it's divisible. Quantity by temperature dT of 1 degree Celsius is known as heat capacity at that is of a constant pressure here. A new quantity born here after or on the behalf of that is of by considering of that is of enthalpy here. Once again here, suppose I select here this box as a system here and keeping here pressure as a constant here to increase the temperature of 1 degree Celsius or dT, the absorbed heat delta QP will be equal to that is of del H, the quantity is known as heat capacity at constant pressure and is symbolized by that is of a CP. We will deliver tomorrow the mayor very special topic, a content that is of Mayer relation, or what is the relation between that is of CP and that is of a CV. We will derive tomorrow the relation between CP and CV of ideal gas, why CP is greater than that is of CV. We will derive it that is of tomorrow, definition of specific heat at constant pressure and that is of heat capacity and constant volume here. I will derive tomorrow my relation, or in other word that is the relation between CP and CV. Thank you very much.